start off with a bit of a summary of last week, really. So interest rate cuts in the Eurozone and China, with another bit of QE from MPC in the UK, certainly led to a bit of volatility on that Thursday. Although that big move really on the MPC at midday on Thursday, I think a lot of people were putting it down to QE, but actually it was more down to the Chinese rate cuts really. US dollar made sharp gains as the global slowdown dampened the mood following these central bank moves. And to cap it off last week, US non-farm payroll showed gains of only 80,000, despite some encouraging ADP data the previous day. It's an interesting one, the difference between the US non-farm payroll and the ADP data. ADP data is, it's kind of like payroll data that companies use. It's some software, I think, that companies use for processing payroll. So use those stats, and it's the most used bit of kit, I think, out there in the States. So it's quite interesting the disparity there. You know, we were expecting 97,000 jobs, but came in at 80. So it's a pretty disappointing figure. What was quite interesting as well was it's quite a big revision higher, however, of the previous month's data. And I don't know if you remember, and I was talking last time about you know, when we had non-farm payroll, and the data was out on the 1st of June, and I was saying you've got to expect some pretty reasonable revisions, because there's no way they can compile a month's data by 8:30 in the morning US Eastern time on the 1st of the month. I mean, you know, so we ended up with some pretty major revisions as well. Those of you